Hi friends, welcome back to Canada Tried and Tested. When someone is planning to move international, the challenge is you want to carry as much as item as possible with you, be it emotional, be it practical, whatever it is, you want to carry as much as possible. But airlines have their own restriction in terms of a number of baggage what you can carry, as well as they have a specific dimension. And if you don't match both of these, you end up paying excess baggage. And this is the challenge I too had when I was moving from India to Canada. And how I overcame that? By getting carton boxes instead of going for suitcases. So I'll be sharing not just, you know, how I got these carton boxes for free, with few additions to this carton box, which costed me less than 100 rupees. I got everything from India to Canada safe, secure, and without any tension. And after I landed here in Canada, I made 5 moves to temporary accommodation before we finally homed on to a long-term accommodation. So do watch this video till the end, as I will be sharing every single thing. And where to get these resources, I have documented that on my website, Canada Tried and Tested, which you can go and check. It's an easy reference for you. You just have to go and do a check on these items. Everything is documented there. So do check out the website also. It is having a lot of useful information. And if you are new to my channel, please go ahead and press the subscribe button, as well as do like, so that you keep getting future videos as I share my experience as a new immigrant and many such saving tips. So the question is, why carton box? As I said, airlines have restrictions. Like when we were traveling from India to Canada, each one of us could carry 2 baggage, and that had to be not more than 23 kg each. And it also had a specific dimension. In our case, it was 150 centimeter. Depending on the type of airlines you have, you will have to check what specification and how much baggage you can carry. And how the airlines also check this is, if it is exceeding 23 kg, or if it is more than 150 centimeter, then you end up paying excess baggage, which could be approximately $200. Not just that, when we were planning to come here, we did not have those bigger suitcases. So we had to make these new purchases, and each suitcase approximately cost 4,500 Indian rupees. And then when I thought about after landing in Canada, how useful that would be only when I'm traveling to India, and how many times do we travel? That also we will have to think. So for me, I did not want to invest money, rather carry things in carton box, so that once I come, I set up everything, I can just dispose it off. And say if I'm traveling to India again and I have to get any of the items, I just follow the same method of getting that in carton box. And it's super easy, super lightweight, and you really don't have to think about how you're going to carry. So I made it very, very simple by having a dolly. So this dolly, I just had to stack the carton box on a dolly and take it. And this dolly costed me $5. So I made it very, very easy for me. Now coming to the carton box, let me show this to you. When I was planning for the carton box, what I did was, the airlines had instruction that the carton box had to be of dimension 150 centimeter. As I said earlier, it's always good to check with your airlines what dimension they allow. And how they measure the centimeter is length plus breadth plus height. So when you take this measurement and this measurement, in total it has to be 150 centimeter. So that was my airline. And my airline, the airline which I had taken, was flying from Bangalore to Dubai and then Dubai to Canada. It was the same airline. In case you have 2 different airline, then double check on if there are any difference between the airlines in terms of what has to be carried. So do check that. So the dimension part I have done with. Now just this carton box is not going to be sturdy. So to make this sturdy, what I did was, I got plastic wrap, the stretchable wrap. It's very inexpensive. You will get anywhere in the hardware store. If not, do check out my website where I have shared all this detail. The stretch wrap you can get through online retail store also. So that stretch wrap, what it does is it gives strength to this carton box, and it also makes it waterproof, and it can take any impact. If somebody is handling in the airline cargo, they are throwing around these boxes, it stays well. I got it till Canada and it came in one piece. So this is Canada tried and tested. So I talked about the carton box, the stretch wrap, and then to seal, you would require a duct tape. I would recommend you to go for a 3M duct tape. They are sturdy and they give you added strength. Now, you will ask, Gopi, what if when I'm going through customs, they ask me to open the carton box? So you really don't have to worry. Carry the duct tape with you in pocket, and you can cut open. So you have the seam, right? So you have the seam, you just have to cut this and then flip it over. And if anything has to be checked, once checking is done, you just bring that back. The stretch wrap is going to be intact along with this. Okay, only thing where you cut, that portion will come out. So you just put the duct tape. Now, when I was doing the packing at home, I was having paper cutter. In case you don't have paper cutter, I'll show you one very easy technique which I learned. So say this is the tape, right? You just have to fold it like this, okay, and pull it. So when you pull, you get this cut. It's as simple as that. You don't even require the paper cutter. So this is done. What you need is the measuring tape to check the dimension of the box, and then weighing scale to make sure that you're not exceeding 23 kg. So the box which I got was of 148 centimeter, so 2 centimeter less than what the dimension was, and it also had printed the length, breadth and height. So there was no confusion on my side, and even if airline wanted to go and check, it was all printed. So it was super, super easy. And where to get these carton boxes? You can go and check with any of the retail shops near you. I went to DMart, Reliance, Metro, Cash and Carry, and they have these product packages which comes. They will be able to figure out for you. I will also be on my website giving you the product package which I used, and it is again available on any of these major retail store. They any which ways don't use, they throw it away. So why don't you repurpose and use it? Once you use it, you just have to throw it. You don't have to even keep that as a storage at home. So it's very, very convenient. Now, the carton box, I did few stress tests since I was carrying, you know, for the first time. I wanted to be sure that it is going to hold 23 kg. So what I did was I increased the weight up till 30 kg. So this 150 centimeter box can easily take weight up till 30 kg. Once you do stretch wrap around, the strength really adds well. And when I compare this carton box, it comes around 300 grams against suitcase, which will be by itself 4.5 kg. So you end up saving a lot more space. If you are carrying the bigger suitcase, the international suitcase, you will have about 18.5 kg at your disposable for packing. And now you also know that the suitcase has compartments, so you will not be able to use optimally all your packing. Whereas in carton box, it was super easy and I was able to pack everything. In fact, I got my mixer grinder also in the carton box, and if mixer grinder can come till Canada, anything can come. It's very delicate, it had no scratch. So this is Canada tried and tested. So once the packing was done, I did the weight check. I had this weighing machine, which I carried along with me, just in case at the airport we get into a situation where there is a difference with what we have weighed versus what the airlines have. I also carried Tata salt, 1 kg Tata salt, which exactly showed the weight on my weighing scale. So that way I had made it foolproof. Now, carrying these carton boxes is easy. I just had to put this in the car. All four carton boxes, two each we could carry, came into these one SUV easily, and one handbag which we carried along with us, and one small bag we carried, which again costed 100 rupees. Both these were hand baggages. So between the airports we had trolleys. We would just stack up in these trolleys, just like any of the suitcase we stack, and we would do the transfer. So once it was handed over to the airline, it was their responsibility to get till Canada. So that was taken care. Once in Canada, again trolleys were available, so we could move these carton boxes on trolley, and then SUVs we used. It was very convenient. We just would get these boxes to the SUVs, and we moved 5 different places before we finally went to a long-term accommodation, and these boxes could sustain all these 5 moves. And finally, after we were settled, I just disposed these boxes. So it saved a lot of storage space, which otherwise we all end up keeping our suitcase, and only time we use is when we are traveling international. Otherwise, usually we carry smaller baggage. So friends, this is how I was able to carry more items without paying any excess baggage. I hope this video helps you when you are planning your international move. And also do use the comment section and let us know, in case you are able to find any carton box of the airline's dimension. So anyone who is coming here gets an easy reference. They just have to go and ask for that box. So I hope you found this video useful. Please do share with your friends and family so that they are also able to carry maximum items when they are planning their international move. Thanks for watching Canada Tried and Tested.